good evening. So it's 9 p.m. on Sunday night. I've just lost my job. Woo! Freedom! I guess. Tomorrow, day off. I have a plan. I should look at the camera here. Look at the camera. I'm not used to this video blogging. So I have a plan. Tonight, I'm going to leave very shortly. And, well, I'll show you. I'm going to leave my place in Sapporo and head to Sapporo's easternmost point, which is Cape, I forget what it was, Nosapu. And watch the sunrise. Then I'm going to double back on myself, go all the way to Obana Cape, which is the westernmost point. Did I get my westernmost right? Well, that's the westernmost point for the sunset. So that's the plan. I'll probably stay somewhere up there tomorrow night and then come back on Tuesday morning. All up, Google says it's a 1,400 kilometer journey. And that's using tollways. I'm not sure if I'm going to stick to that. And it should take me 20 hours. Minus stopping time and coffee breaks and convenience stores and all that. I guess it's my own little cannonball run. I won't be breaking the speed limit because that would be bad. It's 369 kilometers to Cape Nosapu. We've got a full tank of gas, no cigarettes, it's dark, and I'm wearing glasses. Now I just need someone to say, hit it. Hit it.
Starting route guidance to your destination.
First little hiccup. It says I'm not going to get there until 7:10 a.m. I'm sure that'll be recalculated once I get going, but that means I'm going to miss sunrise. All right, so I've just reset the calculations to not paying the toll because it's about 6,000 yen in tolls. So I'm just going to drive the normal route, but the normal routes are telling me it's going to get me there at 10 o'clock, thereabouts. So, yeah, that's no good. But anyway, let's soldier on. Does it take 10 hours to drive 473 kilometers? Seriously. I'm just chilling out here at a set of traffic lights. 6.4 kilometers completed so far on my journey. It's been pretty uneventful. Except I almost got hit by a train. That was exciting. Alright, so it's 4:25 a.m. and I've just driven through the night from one side of Hokkaido to the other. If you think of Japan, I'm at the easternmost point of Japan. Now there's some islands you'll see over there, which I think they're Russia actually. But yeah, this is Nosapu, Cape Nosapu, the most eastern point in Japan. And I'm here just in time for sunrise, 14 minutes to spare. It's quite unbelievable actually. So there it is, the sun's up. It's a beautiful morning here in eastern Japan, eastern Hokkaido. I left Sapporo about 9 o'clock last night and I just got here on time for this. Really, really tight. But anyway, I made it. Now I'm gonna go and find some breakfast. Might get a little bit of a shut-eye before heading back.
So, I made it, sort of. The easternmost point is just around the corner there. You can't quite see it through the haze. It's over there. And you can't get to it. There's a guy with a motorbike. Sorry, on the internet. There's his motorbike on the point. So I don't know. I can't work out how to get there. So, I guess I'm going to be enjoying the sunset from here. It's not a bad spot. So I'm pretty close to the easternmost point of Hokkaido. So I've raced the sun from Sapporo to Nemuro, or out there, and then raced it back, and I've got quite a bit of time before the sun sets. You know, it's still way up there. We've got about an hour and a bit. A lot of driving, a lot of driving. I haven't driven like that for a very long time. I've done about 1,400 kilometers in the last, 1,200 kilometers in the last, since 9 p.m. last night. I've had about 20 minutes sleep. I am absolutely bushed. So, yeah, I'm just going to chill out here and watch the sunset. The road in, this road here, this is a gnarly little road. Just around the corner is this little fishing village, and it's unbelievable. So, I mean, it's run down, it's abandoned homes, but the road is, you know, this tiny little track, you know, it's one car wide. You can see just this one car, and there's little pockets for passing where you have to pull over and let the other car go past you. But people live up there. It's unbelievable. It's really quite a beautiful spot. Yeah. So my drive, I left at 9 p.m. last night, and I decided not to use the tollway, highway. I decided to just use the free roads to get to Nemuro and beyond. Cape no Sapporo, no Poro, I forgot the name already. And driving out there, and it's a beautiful night, about 23 degrees when I left. I'm just driving along, and then you get stuck in all these trucks who are doing their midnight deliveries, and there's truck after truck after truck, and you're just like, come on. And I'm watching the distance to the Cape, and I'm watching the way, I know when the sunrise is due at 4:39 it was, and I'm like, come on, I gotta get there. And I'm averaging out speeds and what speed do I have to maintain to get there, and you know, for a long time I'm under the speed average required. And then after I went through Obihiro, and there's just traffic light stop. After Obihiro, the road was beautiful. And then as I got towards Kushiro, we began a really heavy mist and fog. And so I had to like just slow right down to a crawl, and I'm just crawling along, and there's trucks and there's fog. And then after Kushiro, I'm driving along, and there's just deer everywhere. None on the road, or there was one roadkill, but there was just deer pocketed along. He's just like, there's a deer. A couple of foxes, didn't care about the foxes. It was the deers I was worried about. And, but then I got there and it was all good. Took the photos and got in the car, typed in my destination to return. I was like, wow, I have to leave now. There was no way I could get back to this side of the island without going on the tollway. So I'd use the tollway. 7,000 yen cost me. 7,000 yen. Ouch. I've used 1.5 tanks of gas. So all up, this has cost me about 15,000 yen so far. Can't be more than that. 19,000 yen so far, and I'm probably going to try and find a place to stay tonight out here. Although I might have to go home. I've got some work emails backing up. A different job. So I might see if I can find a better spot to... there's the car. She's done well. I might see if I can find a better spot for the sunset. It's a nice spot. Nice and quiet. But the sun will just be on the water. A bit of landscape would be nice. All right, I'll go and look for that. You'll have to forgive the blown out image, but there's the little fishing village here. You can see the boats. And you go, that village doesn't equal that many boats. And right at the top of the hill up here behind me, there's a village. All these really nice modern homes. I guess these fishermen are doing quite well for themselves, and they've moved the village well out of our tsunami range. We're a long way up here. Yeah, it's a long way, so has to be a very big tsunami to get to the village. So I think this is where I'm going to enjoy my sunset. It looks like a pretty good spot. Got some nice rocks, the village. So while it's not the easternmost point, which I can see over there, well, kind of see, this is where I'll be enjoying my sunset from today. It's 6 p.m. and the village just started playing a song. I guess it means something. It's like, day's over, go home everybody. Don't know. Yep, 6 p.m. There we go. There's the sunset. And a very, very nice.
I can say today has been mission accomplished, almost.
Now, I head home.
The Crabber Hotel.
I am stuck in my car. I cannot get out. I get wet.